think I'm on.
Oh, my Lord.
Look out now.
Look out.
I think they're all set, and when it comes to great singing and great guitar picking, these folks, I think, are one of the finest. They record for the Rounder and the Shanaki record people. Let's make them welcome here, Norman and Nancy Blake.
Thank you, thank you. Well, I just want to know if it's hot enough for y'all today. No, not yet. Well, maybe it'll get hot enough before the day's over for us. Y'all just kind of lay back, and we'll see if we can play some good, easy-going old-time music for you here. Here's one we tried to start out with called A Youth in Dixie.
I'm longing to see. Are you from Alabama? that Mason-Dixon line.
You from Dixie,
I said from Dixie. No, oh, I'm from Dixie.
Well, thank you very much. That's an old song that was written in New York City right there, back in the Tin Pan Alley days, early ones. And it became a sort of a popular hit of about 1916 or 18, I think, somewhere back in there, 11. But it was written right in New York City by a crafty songwriter. Kind of found its way over into the country music tradition a little bit. Well, we'll see if we can pick something for you on the guitars. How about going on up into the D chord there? Here's a couple, the old Fiddler's Graham and maybe the Whiskey Before Breakfast. I hope y'all ain't had no whiskey before breakfast now. Sing you one of our own songs. This is one we recorded somewhere back around 1984, I think it was. And I heard the old record the other day and it didn't sound too bad. It sounded kind of long ago and far away. And I don't know, kind of like the song, even though the Time has come and gone, but it's like a lot of those things. Time marches on. It's called We're Living in the Future. We like to sing it for you. Hope you'll find it amusing today. What you got to look out for this weekend is not to fall off of the world. Sometimes the world gets to moving pretty fast. We're going to try kind of a quiet little tune on the mandolin. This is a tune that a good buddy of ours made up there, one of his creative moments. Mr. Peter Ostrushko from up in Minneapolis plays mighty fine mandolin. He wrote this little tune. He called it The Long March Through Texas. And it's kind of a laid-back little thing. We'll see if we get Nancy to play it for you here today. Mm-hmm. Thank you. Well, I'd like to try one for you here in the open key of A there. I'd like to do one here that's called My Dear Old Southern Home. Let's see if I can find a place to start. I'm going to slow it down a little bit. Get one second, Fred. I'm going to sing you one that I wrote called The Green Light on the Southern, if I might today. The Green Light on the Southern is about old time steam railroad. 1925, the president of the Southern Railroad went over to England and he saw a lot of locomotives running on the British railways that were painted green and gold, and he got the idea that some of those would look good running down through the meadows of the Great Southland. The Southern Railroad at that time had about 5 branch lines, and I was raised up in the 1940s alongside the branch line called the AGS, or the Alabama Great Southern. They had 22 trains a day came through there. We didn't have anything but a battery radio, and lived kind of back in the edge of the woods there, and the trains were a pretty exciting thing. And a lot of my people worked for the railroad as well, and so railroading and steam technology has always been a pretty common topic around the house when I was coming up. And I'd like to sing it for you, The Green Light on the Southern. Standing on the sidetrack at the south end of town, on a dry, hot, dusty August day, the steam pipe blowing down. The fireman with his lawnmower can all in the old valve gear, waiting for the fast mail train, the semaphore to clear. The engineer in the old light cab is no watch in his hand, looking at the water glass and letting down the sand, rolling out on the old main line, taking up the slack. Gone today, but so they say, tomorrow he'll be back. Oh, if I could return to those and the green light on the southern railroad line. Creeping down the rusty rails of a weed-grown branch line, the section out is gray and white by the yard limit sign. The hawkers call the old eyeball, no more time to wait. Rolling down to Birmingham with a 10-car local freight. The whistle screams with a hiss of steam, the headlight gleams clear. The driver roll on the green and gold, getting mighty near. Handing up the orders to the engine crew on time. It's the Alabama Great Southern AGS Railroad Line. Oh, if I could something on the fiddle and the cello now. Nancy Tennessee likes to do one that we know called the Georgia Railroad. I guess it'd follow right along after that. Pretty good. It's another railroad thing. I've been marked. I think my mother must have been marked by a locomotive or something there. Have certainly enjoyed starting things off today. Glad to see each and every one of you.
Good morning.
I'm even going back down and getting the right key, and maybe you all do the same thing.
All you wanted.
But we have certainly enjoyed it, and we are going to be back around, I guess, doing a couple other things today. I think I got some kind of a workshop with Charlie Sautel and Allison Brown, I believe, a little bit later on, around 3 o'clock, something like that. And then I heard a rumor that me and my good buddy Tony Rice was going to pick a couple a little later on. And I always look forward to that. And, So we'll see you a little bit later. Here's a tune we'll go off with. This is called Mr. Garfield Been Shot Down.
Yeah.
Shot way down low. Mr. Garfield's been shot down, shot down, shot down. Mr. Garfield's been shot down low. Mr. Garfield's been shot down, shot down, shot down. Mr. Garfield's been shot down low. Well, I was walking downtown the other day, down the street over by the depot. I heard the report of a pistol. I said, now what does this mean? Feller standing over there, reared back, he gave me something sort of like this. Mr. Garfield's been shot down, shot down, shot down. Mr. Garfield's been shot down low. Mr. Garfield's been shot down, shot down, shot down. Mr. Garfield's been shot down low. Well, friends, I looked over there across the street and I seen a house. I figured that's where they had Mr. Garfield laid out because there's a great big crowd gathered around. I decided I'd go over there and see if I could see him. About the time I got there, the doctor come riding up, he threw down his saddle packets and he run in the house. He took one look at Mr. Garfield. He said, Mr. Garfield, if you should die today, where do you think you'd spend eternity? Mr. Garfield, he looked up kind of sad, and he gave him something like this. I'd make my home in hell, Lord, oh. Make my home in hell. Well, the doctor, he said, that won't ever do. He said, we better send for a preacher. Well, they sent for the preacher, and the preacher come. He got down on his knees, and he prayed him a great long prayer, then he got back up. He said, now, Brother Garfield, if you should die tonight, or you think you'd spend eternity? Mr. Garfield looked up and gave him something like this. I think that home in heaven, Lord, Lord. Make my home in heaven. Yeah. Well, folks, about that time, Miss Garfield, she come into the room. She said, Mr. Garfield.
James?
She called him James. Mr. Garfield. If the worst should come to the worst, and you should not get well, would you want me to marry again? He looked up at her friends, real sad-like, with tears all in his eyes. He gave her something sort of like this. Don't you never let a chance go by, Lord God. Never let a chance go by. Well, now, friends, there's an awful big crowd gathered up there that day around that house. After a while, some of them, they decided that they'd fix dinner. I decided I'd stay and eat with them. There's this town dude there, and ask him what he'd have. He'd give him something like this. Oh, pass around your helm and your egg. Oh, no. Pass round your helm and your ring. There's this old country feller there, and ask him what he'd have. He said, well, just give me something I'm used to. Then he reared back and he give him something sort of like this. Oh, bring on your bacon and your beans, Lord, Lord. Bring on your bacon and your beans. Well, it's getting late. I had to go on home. I didn't get back to town for a couple of days. I come back to town, the very first thing I seen was Miss Garfield. She was walking down the sidewalk and she had a bunch of roses in her hand. I said, Miss Garfield, where are you going with those roses? She gave me something like this. Oh, bless them on my husband's grave, oh Lord. Bless them on my husband's grave. I said, Miss Garfield, where'd you bury him at? And she said, I buried him on that long flowery branch, oh Lord. Buried him on that long flowery branch. Well, folks, I can miss the walking on down the sidewalk. Very next thing I seen was the sheriff. He walked right up to this feller. He stuck a .44 right up in his face, right up under his nose. He said, is your name Charles Couture? Feller, he said, well, he said, yes, sir. He said, sometimes it passes for him. That old sheriff, he rired back and gave him something sort of like this. You're the very man I want, Couture, Couture. You're the very man I want, Charles Couture. Well, now, folks, they carried Charlie Couture on down to that jailhouse. They locked him up in the cell. After a while, I got in there to see him. Charlie didn't look like he was feeling too good, though. I said, Charlie, get to old boy, how you feeling? He looked up kind of sad like, good people. This is what he said to me. I'll hang on the 10th of June, oh Lord. Hang on the 10th of June. Mr. Garfield's been shot down, shot down, shot down. Mr. Garfield's been shot down, oh. And we do thank you. Thank you so much. A couple of things we'll do for you. Old Grimes and the Star of Bethlehem. Thank you very much. We appreciate it. We've got some more fine musicians waiting backstage here. Thank you.